So guys, let's check out the connection diagram, and the connections to be made are pretty much straightforward. The PZM module comes with UART interface, whereas it has to be connected to one UART interface of the ESP32 module over here. So the ESP32 module that I'm using over here, the TTGO LoRa module particularly, comes with two hardware serial ports exposed, but we can't use that because one is being used for programming and stuff, and the second one, that RX pin is used for OLED reset. So here I'll not be using the hardware serial port, rather than I'll be using software serial. For that, actually you can use any digital IO pin, and over here I'm using pin number 13 and pin number 21. So this particularly over is a mistake. Actually this is pin number 21. So pin number 21 is used as TX pin, whereas pin number 13 is used as RX pin. One disclaimer over here, the PZM module comes with 5V TTL, whereas the ESP32 module supports 3.3V. So over here, when connecting the TX pin of the ESP32 module to the RX pin of PZM module, we don't need any sort of logic level shifter because the 3.3V output can be pretty much detected by PZM module. But when we are feeding the output of the PZM module, which is again 5V over here, to the ESP32 board which supports 3.3V, we need some sort of logics level shifter. So over here I am using 2N7000 FET as a logic level shifter, but you can use anything that you are having around. So the 2N7000 along with couple of resistors over here is used as logic level shifter. So if you want a simple solution without using any FET and all, you can simply use a resistor divider, and which will output 3.3V whenever there is input of 5V and all. But that doesn't work with high speed communication. So over here that will work if you, as long as you are using, you know, baud rate of 9600 and around. But if you are going for high speed, that won't work. So FET is going to be a better situation in high speed communication and all. But for low speed, a resistor divider will also work. Also, you can use any other logic level shifter that you are having. So if you want to know more about 2N7000 at logic level shifter, you can check out my earlier video on this, for which there is a link down below in the description. So that's all with connection pretty much. And one more thing, the 5V gets connected to the 5V of PZM module, ground connected to ground, and I'm using the 3.3V output of from the TTGO module over here to the my FET circuit, which is acting as a logic level shifter. So that's pretty much all about it, hardware connections and all, because the OLED module and the LoRa module is there itself in the board. So we don't need any external connections for that apart from the PZM module. So that's all with connection and all. So I'll just quickly connect my circuit accordingly to this schematic diagram, and then after we'll jump to the code part. So guys, let's check out the code, and over here I am going to use Arduino IDE. So let's open it up, this code.ino file, and as well as there is another file config.h which holds all the configuration for this project. So you can download this codes from this particular GitHub repository, which is the link to the repository is down below in the description. So you can pretty much go through it. It has all the schematics and pin diagrams and everything you need for this project. So I'll just minimize it, and this is the code particularly. And over here I'm going to use three libraries, namely for the OLED U8x8, for the LoRa module that is LMIC, and for software serial that is ESP266 or ESP software serial, I suppose. So I'll just go ahead and install the libraries pretty quick. Okay, after the libraries are in place, we can go through the code, but before that, just make sure you have added the BSP for ESP32 and your particular board, that is over here, TTZO LoRa 32 OLED module is available in the board list. So over here for me it is there, and I have also selected the port that it is connected to. So make sure you have the drivers in place and you have also added the support for ESP32 to your Arduino IDE. Now let's just go through the code once. So I'll just let you through the important parts over here. So over here we have defined the pins that is being used by the onboard LoRa module and that is connected to the ESP32 and all. After that, I have this array of hexadecimal bytes that corresponds to different commands for the PZM module. So this can be fetched from this particular data sheet of the PZM module, and yeah, you can see over here for voltage, this is a command and it starts with head and it's some checksum at the end. So this particular hexadecimal bytes array holds true if the address of the module is 192.168.1.1. So if your module's address is something else, then this won't work and you need to change it. So over here for me it is 192.168.1.1, so this pretty much will work. And if you want to change your address, you can pretty much do that by simply using this command over here. So you can send this command to your device to change the IP address or the address of the device to 192.168.1.1. And this actually I have just copied from the data sheet, nothing else over here. Then there's the onEvent function for LoRaWAN. So it has different functions like EV join, event joining, join and all. And over here we'll be using OTA method. So this joined and joining method is pretty important. After that, join parallel and all those events. So these events are invoked whenever particular event occurs. So this particular function over here, onEvent, gets called and it takes the event also as an input. So based on that, we are just using switch case and all, and nothing else there. I'll just get to that later on. After that, do send, this is a job that we are doing, after a particular interval or something. So it lets you send the data to TTN. So over here we are doing setup, then we are just initializing the serial port. After that we are initializing the software serial port over here, and it takes the baud rate, the parity and all, then the RX pin, text pin and the buffers. After that we are just initializing the OLED display, then we are just making message on the display that's starting and all. After that, we are just defining, checking if the region for LoRaWAN is correctly defined or not. So for me over here, if you want to change the region, so you can get into documents or wherever your Arduino libraries are there, and get into the LMIC library page, folder. After that, get into project config. And you just need to make sure your region is properly configured over here. So for me, it is it's going to be India 866. So I'll just comment this out, US 915, and my region is now configured over here. Also, if you just make sure your radio is particularly properly configured. So just close it. So based on your region, you need to config this LMIC project config.h file. So yep, that's it. After that we are initializing the LMIC and all. LMIC is set, then I'm invoking a function update meter data, so which will eventually communicate with the meter and update the energy related variables that we have defined earlier. After that I'm just checking in a loop, and I'm just checking the display update interval, and this actually is used to update the display or the OLED module over here. And I have another thing, LoRa data publish interval, so which will be used to configure the publishing interval for LoRaWAN and all. So after each within this intervals, I just call update meter data, and if it is on display, then I'll just update the data over the display. or if it is, you know, for LoRa publishing, I'll just invoke do send. So this is the initialize wallet function, nothing much over here. We are just printing out some strings and all over the display. And then I have defined a clear wallet line. So if you want to clear a particular line in the display, this can be used. So I'm just doing nothing but printing white spaces. Then set LoRa message, that will help you set a particular string over the OLED module. After that, this is quite where the meter communication happens. So over here we are just fetching voltage or whatever parameter it is, like voltage, current or energy, anything. Then we are just converting the received bytes into proper meaningful data. So over here, what I've done is I have declared another array, LoRa data packet, and I'm just assigning the received data bytes into this LoRa packet array. So this will make sure I have always consistent size and the bytes are in order whenever I'm sending data to TTN. So there it can be processed easily. Later on, we have this phase data function, which actually send out the command that we are sending from here, or particularly this array that we are sending, like voltage, current or whatever it is, which is defined earlier, this one. So what it does is it takes this array based on the command we are passing and writes into the serial port, and after that it waits for a certain time, like 10 seconds for me. So it will just either wait for 10 seconds or it will wait for 7 bytes of data. So it will write the comment and it will wait till it gets 7 bytes, or there is a timeout of 10 seconds, and it will just read those data into this PZM response buffer. So nothing else there. After that, we are using this PZM buffer for calculating the voltage and all the parameters depending upon the command that we have used. Then I have a simple debug function over here, so that print the BJDM buffer data into the serial console. So that's all in this code over here. So let's look at the config.h file. Here we are having TTN keys and the timing intervals that we want to do, like update the display or we want to send the data. After that, we are having the pin definitions for software serial. So for me, it is 13 and 21. You can pretty much use any other pin that you want. Just make sure it is not being used internally with any other OLED module or the LoRa module. So I'll do one thing. I'll register my application and copy the keys to this config.h file. So for that, I'll just get into the Things Network website and the console. So I'll get into applications. So I'll create an if you want to change the display update interval or LoRa data publish interval, you can change pretty much over here. For me, I'll just go with this. And there's one more thing over here. We are actually sending out the data in, just as an array of bytes and all. So we need to decode that in TTN. To do that, I'll just get into my application and I'll get into payload formats, and there's a decoder over here. So I'll just go ahead and copy this. Actually, I've already written. So you can find this in my repository. So this will convert the payloads received into meaningful data like voltage, current, power and energy. So over here you can see I am deriving current from power and voltage because I want to minimize the data that I'm sending using LoRaWAN and all. Because current is always power or voltage, so I'm not sending that data to TTN. So yeah, that's it. I'll just say payload functions, scale your data. So that's all about the code, guys. I'll just upload the code, but the module that I have connected to my PC is not connected to any PZM module. So I'll have data, but all should be zero. So let's just upload and confirm that code works.